Assalamualaikum everyone. Back with me, Liana, your host for today. Our topic would be terrorism and aviation industry. Aviation industry is one of the industries that has the highest risk in security terms. Terrorism is one of it. Terrorism is an unlawful act of violence or intimidation towards innocent civilians, usually for the pursuit of political aims. Attacks against aviation industry is not something new. It started all the way back in 1930s. In 1931, Peruvian revolutionaries tried to force a pilot to fly to the place he was commanded. This event happened after 17 years of the first commercial flight took off. As of today, there are a number of militant groups emerged since the 9/11 incident. One of the most famous militant group would be Islamic State, ISIS. And these militants have caused a lot of casualties and deaths to their innocents. One of the most recent terror attack of these terrorists is the Brussels airport bombing. On March 2016, three coordinated suicide bombings happened in Belgium, two in the airport and one at Malbeek metro station in central Brussels. 32 civilians were killed, including three suicide bombers, and more than 300 were injured. ISIS was claimed responsible for the attacks. It was the deadliest act of terrorism in Belgian history. The Belgian government declared 3 days of national mourning. The group launched the attack shortly after a series of police raids targeting their group. Terror attacks are becoming more severe day by day. They even come with trends nowadays, and one of it would be terrorists would recruit aviation personnel itself to help them get through security measures or even get them to do it for you. And in January 2016, a worker and two police officers at Sharm el-Sheikh Airport were arrested on suspicion of involvement in an attack. Currently, the trend is to use tactical and technological knowledge in terror attacks. This would include rockets and drones and also lasers. In November 2015, a pilot of British Airways almost got blinded of the laser that is aimed toward the pilots in the cockpit. A lot of safety measures are being taken to curb these terror attacks. Firstly, is the banning of laptops and large electronic devices from carry-on luggage on flights traveling from 10 airports across Middle East. And this is because many terrorists, they use laptop-based bombs to explode a plane and take it down. Secondly, is the screening of airport employees. This is because they want to stop these employees who may have liaised with this terrorist. How does terrorism affect the economy of the aviation industry? It weakens the demand of people to travel by air. This is because they are concerned with their safety. And of course, terrorism have given a huge loss to airlines companies. For example, EasyJet has lost 34.6 million in just a half year, and they estimated a revenue per seat decline 7%. Terrorism have caused a lot of fatalities aside of affecting the economics of the country as well as the industry. That is all from me now, Liana, your host.